Coach Casey Keeler here after a tough one, Coach. Two great teams going at it. Unfortunately, it kind of has to end the way it ended. But what you see out there today is the difference.
Well, they did a pretty good job executing. And we talked about it at halftime. Just us executing. Their third down conversion rate was unbelievable. And there's too many times that we knew exactly what they were going to do, and we didn't execute. We knew on third and shorts, they were going to run the ball. The quarterback was going to pull it a lot down by the goal line. And we have guys on those guys, and we don't execute. So, you can blame a lot of people, and I wouldn't let the kids blame the officials, because there's obviously some calls we thought should have gone a different way. What we talked about is all we can control is what we can control. And they out-execute us, and you have to give them credit. I thought our kids prepared. I'm so proud of how our kids prepared. It was a championship week, and they played tremendously hard. But, it's about playing cleaner. And I thought Old Dominion played cleaner than we did.
What do you take out of this game moving forward? You obviously, it's looking like now, you need that 8 wins. Now you got 3 left. I know you take it one at a time, right?
Yeah,
but, what do you think?
I told the kids, I said, listen, all I know is that we will prepare like we prepared this week. And all I know is we will come out and fight like we did this week. And if we do that, I like our chances of winning. And that's all we can do. And if we don't win, then we'll take a deep breath and move on to the next game. I was really proud of the kids. We battled. Now we lose our quarterback and we lose Pierce in the first drive of the second half. No one panicked. We kept on playing. Paul was playing on one leg. At the end, that touchdown at the end of the half, Paul's normally out there in that position, but we had to switch him because Paul just athletically couldn't be out there in that position. Normally he would be the guy on the quarterback. So, we fought through some adversities, but proud of the kids and anxious to have another great week of practice and go play Towson.
And now we bring in Paul Worrilow from the defense. Paul, Coach just said, you're basically playing on one leg. Tell us a little bit about your status right now.
I'm feeling pretty good right now. I know. Once I get all the gear off and get on the bus, I'm probably going to stiffen up real bad. But, it took a lot of work, rehab to get out here for this game. And it was definitely worth it. We all played our butts off all game. It was a battle.
Tell us about their offense. It looked like they were dinking and dunking you guys a lot and then trying to take some opportunistic shots. Was it anything you weren't expecting, or was it just kind of one of those things where they were executing like Coach was saying?
Yeah, they did exactly what we expected them to do. And, we executed our game plan. You saw drives where when everyone was in the right spot, we were getting off in 3 downs. We were forcing turnovers. And so we kind of feel like we gave them some points, just like, simple communication errors, people not being where they're supposed to be at the snap of the ball. So we definitely feel like we gave them a little bit. They played hard, though. Hats are off to them, and we played hard. So,
what do you feel like your locker room is right now? Obviously you got a long way to go, but every game's important. So as you guys try to make a run towards the playoffs, you feel like everybody's in good spirits?
For the most part. This hurts. It hurts real bad. I'm hurting. All the guys in there are hurting. But you let it hurt. It's supposed to hurt. You want it to. And then, so the bus ride home, it's not going to be a joyous thing. We're not really looking forward. You want to just let it hurt, let it sink in, know that, next week we don't want to come out with this result. We got to do everything in our power to come out next week with a W.
All right, Paul, appreciate you coming out here in the weather and on one leg, as Coach was saying. Get yourself healthy, man.
All right, thank you.
Michael Johnson, State Farm Insurance, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Michael led the team with catches with 5. You had the acrobatic one-handed catch, but I have to start by asking you about the final play because you were involved in there. What happened out there? Did you feel like that there should have been a flag? Can you kind of take us through that?
Well, we just really didn't execute. It's not just the last play. It's throughout the whole game. We had chances to make plays and go up by a lot, but we just didn't.
I know it's hard to talk about individual feats after a tough loss, but going back to the beginning of the game, one of the best catches we've seen all year. You look like you were excited about it. Kind of take us through that play down at the goal line, that one-handed catch.
Well, the play at the goal line, it's a play call for me. So the quarterback threw the ball, and the coach always preached about make plays, so that's what I did. I went up and made a play.
It seems like your wide receiving core is just growing. Trent's got a lot of guys that he likes to go to. You've obviously been one of them. Milburn, we saw Nijah in the second half a lot today. Talk about your wide receiving core and how that's kind of developed over the course of the year.
Well, we practice real hard. We practice on our ball security. We practice on everything. And, we're a real tight group. So just practice. It's all practice. We do overtime with our quarterbacks and that's how we build our chemistry.
All right, appreciate you coming out here, spending a few minutes in the rain. Go get yourself dry, and we'll see you next week.